Good morning, students. This lesson is of class 6 for the subject of geography. Chapter 1, Globes and Maps, which we will continue from page number 14 of your textbook titled Madhuban ICSC Geography 6 and is being submitted to you on 19th April 2021. This voice is of Millie Bhatnagar. Students, in the previous lecture, we had studied about the scale of a map. According to scale, maps have been divided into two categories. Small scale maps. These maps are used to indicate a very large area with few details. The map on the wall of your classroom or in an atlas are small scale maps. Large scale maps. These maps are used to show a very small area with many details. The guide map of cities used by tourists and the layout of maps of villages and towns are large scale maps. Conventional symbols. The maps that we use are very small in size. They contain very less space, but we have to show a lot of information of a large area on a map. This creates a problem. So, to solve this, different colors, symbols, signs, and letters are used. Different countries have mutually agreed upon the common use of signs, symbols, and colors in the maps. A proper understanding of these signs and symbols is necessary to understand any information given on a map. For example, throughout the world, green color is used to show plains, and blue color represents oceans and seas. These signs and symbols are conventional signs and symbols. Key or legend is a sort of index which explains about the colors, symbols, and patterns used on a map. In a map, we usually find it at the bottom, in the right or the left corner. Let us take a short break. You are requested to kindly pause your audio for 3 to 4 minutes and write the answer for the following questions in your notebook after listening to it carefully. Number one, what are small scale maps? Number two, give one example of large scale maps. Number three, what are conventional signs and symbols? We will now discuss the answers. Number one, small scale maps indicate a very large area with few details. Number two, the guide map of cities used by the tourist. Number three, the conventional signs and symbols are the sign language for any map, with the help of which people of any country can interpret the maps of any other country across the world. A sketch is a rough drawing which is drawn without using a scale or any conventional sign or symbol. Let us try to understand this through an example. Suppose your friend has invited you to her or his house for a dinner. She or he make a rough drawing for you to reach her or his house. He or she will show in the drawing name of streets and roads and arrows to show where to turn. Also, the landmarks like post office, cinema halls, etc. that will help you find her or his house. Such a drawing is called as a sketch. You can see the sketch given on page number 17 of your book for a better understanding. Plan an accurate map of a very small area, like a house or a building complex, is called a plan. It is based on actual measurement taken on the ground. Such maps contain minute details. Students, we will study here some of the conventional symbols like railway line, roads, metalled and unmetalled, boundaries, international, state, and district boundaries. Then how the river, well, tank, canal, they are shown. This you can see the symbols here. The symbols of temple, church, mosque, chhatri, then post office, post and telegraph office, police station, different kind of settlements, graveyard, trees and grass. Students, we had earlier studied about the topographic maps. So here we will discuss the colors used in topographic maps. Blue color is used to show perennial water bodies. Yellow for cultivable land, green shows the vegetation, white, barren lands, brown, contours and sand features, black color for names, latitudes and longitudes, dry water bodies. And finally, the red color, it is used for human-made features. With this, we end this interactive session. Thank you.